स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक काइंड्स ऑफ डिबेंचर्स। काइंड्स ऑफ डिबेंचर्स मींस हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ डिबेंचर्स कैन बी इश्यूड बाय एनी ऑफ द कंपनीज। मेनली देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ शेयर्स। ऑल फोर टाइप्स हैव टू डिफरेंट कैटेगरी ऑफ इश्यूइंग द डिबेंचर्स। नाउ फर्स्ट इज नेकेड और मॉर्टगेज डिबेंचर्स। नेकेड और मॉर्टगेज्ड, नेकेड एंड मॉर्टगेज डिबेंचर्स। नाउ व्हाट आर दीस नेकेड और मॉर्टगेज डिबेंचर्स? नेकेड डिबेंचर्स आर दोज डिबेंचर्स ऑन विच नो मॉर्टगेज इज कैप्ट बाय द कंपनी। मॉर्टगेज मींस गिरवी रखना। व्हेनेवर वी टेक अ लोन फ्रॉम एनी पर्टिकुलर बैंक और we have to keep sometimes a property as mortgage. So whenever company issues debentures, sometimes company gives some mortgage for repaying that particular amount of debentures. So but naked debentures are those debentures as where no, which is no secured debentures and no property is pledged or mortgage on their issues. Means if company fails to pay or company goes for any problem, company goes for any of the default, the debenture holder cannot claim for repayment or for his money. But mortgage debentures are those debentures where property or a particular assets is kept as mortgage by the company, and if company goes for any default, that particular debenture holder can claim for that particular assets, and that assets cannot be disposed of by the company before the repayment of that debentures. So this naked debentures are also called unsecured or insecured debentures, but the mortgage debentures are called secured debentures, as there is a security of keeping the assets behind the debentures. Now next, second is what? Second is redeemable or irredeemable debentures. Redeemable or irredeemable. Not all, we should say and. Irredeemable. Now what are these redeemable and irredeemable debentures? Redeemable debentures are those debentures which are to be redeemed at a specified date. Suppose company issued redeemable debentures on 1st January 2017 and company says that after 5 years, means on 31st March 2022, it will be redeemed. Then on that specified date or before that specified date, any time when a company wishes, company will redeem those debentures, means the repayment will be done. But irredeemable debentures are those debentures which are not be redeemed during the lifetime of the company. It is not at the company's option or neither at the option of the debenture holders. Clear? Now third, bearer or registered debentures. Bearer and registered. Bearer debentures are those debentures which are having, which can be issued to anybody else by the debenture holders without any information to the company, and their name is also not written anywhere in the list of the debenture holders. Anytime the nominee can be changed, a person who is having this debenture can give it to anybody else. But the registered debentures are those debentures which are to be registered in the books of the company, where the list of the holders of these debentures is maintained, and that cannot be transferred, the interest of this cannot be transferred in the hands of others without any formalities or without prior information of the company, where if the company permits, only then these debentures can be issued to, or interest can be transferred to anybody else. Fourth and last type of debentures is convertible and non-convertible debentures. Convertible and non-convertible debentures. Now what is this? What is convertible debentures? The debentures which can be converted into shares at the option to convert the debentures into equity shares after a specified period, that is called convertible debentures. There are few debentures which can be converted into equity shares at the option. If the debenture holder wants and the company wants to convert it into equity shares, company may convert, but after a specified period, maybe after 3 years, 4 years or 5 years, it can be converted. But those debentures which cannot be converted into equity shares or any kind of shares during the lifetime of the company is called non-convertible debentures. So here this topic ends. There are four types of debentures: naked debentures or mortgage debentures, redeemable and irredeemable debentures, bearer and registered debentures, and convertible and non-convertible debentures. Now next, what we are going to discuss here in this lecture is how the debentures are advantageous from the viewpoint of debenture holders. Means the advantages of debentures. Advantages of debentures. First is from the viewpoint of debenture holders. Appeal to the cautious investors. Large amount of finance can be raised by issue of debentures from cautious and orthodox investors. There are many investors who do not want to buy the shares of the company because shareholders of the company sink or swim with the company. But debentures are a secured investment. They are considered as a secured investor. There are many cautious and orthodox holders, investors who do not want to invest money in the shares, but they invest a large amount of their money or investment into debenture holders. So this is one of the point. It is appeal to the cautious investor. Second is regular return. Dividend is paid regularly on the debentures, which is very beneficial for the point of view of debenture holders. And it is paid regularly whether the company earns money or not. Irrespective of profit or loss, company pays the dividend, interest on debenture. And safety of investment. Debentures are usually secured by a charge on company's assets. Most of the time company issues mortgage debentures or secured debentures. So it is also security for the investors. Now how it is advantageous from company's viewpoint? First is economical source. Company has to pay very less amount on the issue of debentures. Company is not supposed to pay brokerage and share issue expenses is paid in while issuing the shares. Company has to pay a very minimum amount of a nominal charge for issuing the debentures. Nominal expenses are done by the company. So it is very economical source and freedom of management. Whenever a company wants to issue debentures, company has not to take permission from anywhere else. There is a flexibility. Company can issue the debentures at any time when company is in profit and company has a huge amount of profit, company may pay it off. Trading on equity is also done. Company may issue with the amount of this debentures, company may use as a equity. There is flexibility. Company can raise up to any amount company can raise through capital through the issue of debentures. And there is also tax relief because interest paid on debentures is allowed a deduction while calculating taxable amount. Tax is deducted out of the interest paid to the debenture holders and that tax is paid to the government, it results in saving in income tax liability. So income tax liability of the company gets reduced. So here this topic ends. In our next lecture, we will be discussing about the disadvantages of debentures. Till then, thank you. Goodbye.